Since you're watching this video, I guess your computer is running with some issue here as you're trying to open up a web recently installed, one of these error arrived. The problem can start because the MSVCP140.dll is missing from your computer, or the code execution cannot proceed, VCRuntime140.dll was not found. These are the exact same problem and it has the similar solution as well. Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Evolution. In the following 3 minutes, I'll be solving two problems. So let's get started. Consider subscribing to the channel if the video helps you. To download the DLL, first go to Google and search for MSVCP140.dll. Choose the first Google result. This video is not sponsored, but I'll put the link in the description. Here you can see few download options based on the computer architecture and version. If you don't know your computer architecture and version, click on start and search for system information. You can see mine is a 64-bit PC and I am updated, so let's choose the first one. The download will be started. Inside the downloaded zip, we can see the DLL file in it. And similarly, search for VCRuntime140.dll, choose the first result, then choose the first result as well for downloading, and download will start and we can see the DLL file in the zip file. In order to move the DLL, you need to first open this PC, then local disk C, Windows, and find a folder name system32. There it is. This is the home of 32-bit DLL files. Then click on the MSVCP140 zip, drag the DLL, and drop. And click on continue to give administrator access. And similarly, drag the VC runtime DLL and drop. And click on continue. This is the summary of the process. This is only applicable if you are a 64-bit users. You need to open this PC one more time, local disk C, Windows, and find a folder name syswow64. Then click on the MSVCP140.dll and drop. And click on continue. Similarly, click on the VC runtime DLL, drag the DLL and drop. Click on continue. And finally, restart your computer. This is the summary of the process. Every computer is different. In some special cases, if the error still occurs, you need to go to Google and search for Microsoft Visual C++ download, and then click on the download button and choose your Windows version. Click on next. You can read the install instruction as well. Download is starting and it's an exe file. And that's all. If you follow me step by step, you no longer have that problem left. Consider giving me super thanks if the video helps you. And let me know if you have any questions. Connect our social medias and do not forget to like and subscribe.